Good evening and welcome back to my living room concerts. Tonight is severely unusual, even for me. If you don't like contemporary classical music, this episode is not for you. Although we all know that who likes contemporary classical music? Almost nobody. I have a friend. His name is Ljova. Ljova is on the screen. He lives in New York. He's a big time composer. I'm just gonna read off his website. So he had commissions from City of London Symphony, Louisville Orchestra, tons and tons of work for Yo-Yo Ma and a Silk Road Ensemble, quartet for Brooklyn Rider, clarinet quintet for Art of Elan, works for Knights, Sybarite, I don't even know who those people are, work with San Francisco Symphony, Los Angeles Philharmonic, Detroit Symphony, blah blah blah, worked with there's some amazing names in here that I totally like. Anyways, so he's super, he's wonderful, he's great. In 2001, I wrote the piece that I'm about to play for you, the day before he posted the thing somewhere on Facebook or something where he played four violas or four viola parts at different times together with himself, pre-recorded the other parts. And he wrote a piece of music, I believe, that was called For Me, because it was for him. And I thought that I'm gonna write one that is called For You, because it's for him. For you. That's what it's called. I sent it to him, and in his own words, for many years, he was like, no, this is not like, you can't do this. This is too complicated. How am I gonna do this? This is too much work. It's like, how do you synchronize? The score is 26 pages. Forget that it seems to be only 8 minutes long. Anyways, so today I get an email in the morning. It says, hey, I've recorded it. I hope you enjoy. So, without further ado, there's Ljova. Okay, so this is how that works. That's the first viola part, that's the second viola part, that's the third viola part, that's the fourth viola part. This is the vocal part, which I totally forgot that in 2001, I wrote the part that you're supposed to sing in. So when you look at the, well, I'm probably gonna pause after the movements and talk a little bit. Anyways, so that's the first movement, and it says For You, dedicated to my friend, Mr. Ljova Zhurbin. I guess you don't really need to know much about that movement. There is a glissando at the end and the chord that everybody holds together. So you're gonna hear all of this. So we're gonna start. Grand opening movement. The second movement has a comment from the composer, which is me, and it says dreamlike. It introduces sul tasto, which is one of the string techniques. There is sul tasto and there is sul ponticello, which is playing with your bow closer to you and closer to the end of the, I don't know the English words for any of this, but anyways, so for example, the first melody when it appears is just normal, ordinary, as we say, and then the first viola comes after that with a sul tasto effect, and then we have chords on the bottom here and chords on the bottom here, and then it's two-way polyphony again when the first and second viola And at the end, there is a slightly bigger solo with the first viola playing ordinary, and then everything goes to mezza piano and happily resolves into the texture, kind of like the beginning. Let's see what it is. That's that movement with the love theme appearing here and there. The movement number three. So we start with the pizzicati in the second and third viola. And the first viola is playing concertina, which is the mute. And then when the fourth viola comes in on the second system, that's sul ponticello. So you'll hear that really, really weird kind of like teeny sound, and the mute, the concertina is also very like very ethereal and very beautiful sound. Then it goes, everybody is going to arco, which is playing like they usually do with the bow, and then concertina and sul ponticello comes back at the very end. And with that, we are going to the fourth movement, which is has a lot of somewhat imitative musical jokes, which you probably are gonna hear them. Okay, so I'm just gonna read the comments there. In 2001, somebody named Misha wrote in that score. In the first and second viola part, right there, it says, Hen and Lake, high school dropout music. The second one says, same character with the first viola. The third viola has a mark that you probably thought that you would never see in viola music. It says, imitate the large organ, pipe organ. On the third page of this comes the fourth viola, who was asleep all the way through. And the mark on the music says, espressivo. Espressivo would be expression-like, right? Except espresso is actually a drink, and it's spelled different. So this is what it kind of like talks about. Now, that's not at all the end of this. On the fourth or fifth page, whatever, of that movement, in the fourth viola part, it says double the melody note with humming. So you play and you hum. And then a page later, it says change from humming to singing. So you start fully singing everything as loud as you can, and hopefully with the pitches that match what you are actually playing, but it's not essential. Listen to this. So Hannon, then church organ, then humming, then singing. First of all, you've never heard a viola quartet because there is no such thing, or almost no such thing. And second of all, I think that's the best viola quartet ever written. And Ljova's singing is wonderful. I could not have done it better myself, which doesn't say much. Not much of a singer. I tend to marry singers instead. And then sometimes they try to teach me how to sing, and that's a train wreck waiting to happen. Okay, the next movement, allegro. Bum, 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 bum. Nothing unusual so far. I think it's just the allegro, except there's a different character, like, and different... Like typical for the classical symphonic development things, that some things are polyphonic, some things are chordal. But yeah, it's the last movement. So. Thank you. And that's all there is to it. And I was thinking originally that I could possibly, after doing this, record something else after this, as I've piled a bunch of Bach's music with jazz music afterwards. But I think this is about what I want to do. I'm gonna put Ljova's link in the description for this episode, and it made me very, very happy. I don't remember much about writing this thing, but I did write it, and now it actually has a life of its own. And of course, it's published on Shape Music Class, as always. I will put that link in there as well, in case if you have a viola and three other friends who are playing violas. Wasn't that something? It's the strangest music ever. And I think it's fun. It's very contemporary, very kind of like 21st century, something like this. Thank you, Ljova. All right, I'll see you tomorrow night.